Oh, wow. This is cute. I got this big box in the mail today. Somebody in the United States, whom I won't name until or if they give me permission to do so, sent me this box. For $60 it cost them, okay? And these are mung beans, and here it is in French, haricot mungo. And I really appreciate these because, well, for one thing, they printed out a page from the internet about the health benefits of these and stuff you can add them to or whatever. Very, very helpful. And my spouse was laughing because it came with quite a bit of pink bubble pack, and he actually wants that. He's going to repack some other stuff. And also we were laughing because there are two Ziploc bags that came with this stuff. And these I can't get here in France, or if I can, I don't, or I haven't seen them. Although I'm not the one who does the shopping here anymore. And these are so good. I know they're bad for the environment, and I just know they're wrong on so many different levels. But whenever I go away, I really like to use these for some dishwashing soap and definitely some laundry soap, whether it be hand laundry or machine laundry. Saves a lot of space. And these are golden berries. This is pretty cool. I tried these. They're a bit sour like cranberries. And they remind me a little bit of goji berries, but they're larger. And here's a printout on these and where they came from originally and where they're grown now and what they're used for and why they're so beneficial to the health. And this is pretty cool. These are also definitely going to be used pretty quickly. What else came? Now see, this I've heard of, and I don't know what this is. I mean, I've heard of it. And this is a big bottle, 36 ounces, non-GMO, wholesome sweeteners, organic blue agave, a low glycemic sweetener, 25% sweeter than sugar, and it has some suggestions of what you can do with it. Pretty cool. All right. This is a bag of bulghur with vermicelli. And this is so nice. This is really, really sweet. I really like tabbouleh type salads and bulgur wheat dishes. All right. Okay. My French spouse was amazed by rice-a-roni in the United States. You know, that staple of questionable food, which actually he liked very much, and he was thrilled about the TV commercials and was singing the song. And I said to him, sort of like rice-a-roni, sort of. Not. And he liked that. Oh, we have such a joke in this house about kikkoman. I like kikkoman products, and he doesn't. So, and also I like Asiatic style foods or actual Asiatic dishes, and they're pretty deplorable generally in France, unless you're really lucky or do it yourself and know what you're doing. So, whenever he sees any kind of food that looks sort of Asiatic, even in its presentation, he shouts kikkoman. And this is so funny because, you know, it's oyster-flavored sauce, right? But I'm looking at the ingredients and stuff, and it's got no artificial, it's got artificial colors because it's got caramel color in it, but no artificial flavors and no preservatives, and it actually does have some oyster elements in there. I was really missing egg foo young the other day. And, you know, you can forget about finding Cantonese-style food here. So I got out my cookbook, and I made egg foo young. And there was no sauce. It was fine the way it was. But this would have been good and he would have hated it. And then finally, oh, this is really nice. This is from Whole Foods, I believe, some raw honey. And he was looking at this because he got into honey a couple of years ago. And he was like, whoa, I don't know. You know, I got some stuff here from Mexico and Paraguay and the big critic. So thank you very much. This was really, really, really fun. And this will be really, really fun to use. I will get back to you by email. Okay, bye.